Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I wanted to update you guys on some skincare products that have changed in my skincare routine and answer some of your skincare Q&As that you guys left me about like acne and hyperpigmentation, scars and all that. So let's get started. So for those that have not watched my 10-step Korean skincare routine, I will place that video down in the info box. My skincare routine, the steps are pretty much similar from that video, but like 5 other products have changed. So here's my first product. You guys know I've been talking about the Hera Essence for years. I've used this for like 4 years now, but recently they came out with the newer version. So here is how the new version looks like. Okay, so the ingredient is pretty much the same. It's all the same except 2 ingredients have been added. Before it was code 8 with 8 different main ingredients, but now it's code 10. The 2 that has been added into this one is probiotics and prebiotics. Their main thing for their new essence is skin biome, which I have talked about in a few of my skincare videos. It's really important to keep your skin environment healthy. So yes, I have changed my essence to the upgraded version. Another product that has changed in my routine is my moisturizer. I think this is the one I showed you guys before, the Philosophy moisturizer. I've used this for about 2 years now, but online here in Korea, I can't find the same one anymore. I think it might be discontinued. So now I use these 2. I kind of switch on and off between these. This one is Be Plain, the calming moisturizer, pH balanced. I've used this for a few days now and it's very light. Great for daily moisturizer and it doesn't have any fragrance. So it would be perfect for those that have like sensitive skin and are sensitive to like fragrances. It absorbs quickly into my skin and stays hydrated. It's non-sticky. I just now started using this as well. Neogen Vital Dual Night Cream. And there's also a day cream as well. Like a gel type. This is also very hydrating. There's lavender and vitamin E in here. And vitamin E is also good for your skin because it helps like strengthen and protect your skin. I love the smell of lavender. It helps me to like calm down, to relax. So it's perfect for night cream because you're about to go to sleep after applying this. So for the cleanser, I have been using the Clean and Clear for many years now, ever since I moved to Korea, so for like 4 years. But recently it stopped working for me and my face started breaking out. I think every time I start using a product for a really long time, like for years, it just stops working, so I have to find a new product. So it was time. So 1 week ago, I switched my cleanser to the Medicube Red Foam Cleanser. And for the past 7 days, this has been working so well for me. It really helped with my acne. Like I was able to see a difference after just 1 week of using this. Both contain salicylic acid, which works great for me. I really like this cleanser because it has the tiny little microbeads, which kind of helped like exfoliate my skin. But since it was kind of like a gel type of cleanser, it didn't really lather as much and I felt like my face wasn't really cleaning well. But this one, the foam cleanser, it lathers so well and it removes all my makeup. I feel like it removes all my like dirt and oil as well. This has been working great for my acne prone skin and for my pores. So a few weeks ago, I uploaded my anti-aging video and I did show you guys these 2 products from Medicube, the eye cream and then the vitamin C. So these are 2 things that have been added into my skincare routine. Medicube is one of my favorite Korean skincare brand now for both acne and for my anti-aging. This is the Medicube Deep Vita C Ampoule. So in that video, I have mentioned that I've been using this for over a month now. This one's already all gone and I'm currently on this one. It's like a droplet. So I have added vitamin C into my skincare routine because it helps with so many things. It helps fade sunspots. It helps brighten your complexion. It also helps with acne scars, hyperpigmentation. Days when I'm breaking out and my cheeks are like all red, I just apply some of vitamin C on there and then it helps calm it down the next day and it turns less red. I did take a photo of my skin before I started using vitamin C. So here's a picture of before and after. I used it for about a month and a half. When I look in the mirror, I can tell that it's starting to help fade my sunspots and scars. I do have a 20% Medicaid coupon code for you guys to use. I'll place that down in the video info box. I didn't just wash this face and came in here to apply the vitamin C. Okay, now for Q&A, I will answer some of your skincare questions that you guys left me on my Insta story. I will just pick some of the questions. Number one, how to deal with adult acne. When I was younger, I felt like the only way to treat my acne was through like acne medications and products. But as I got older, I kind of learned how to manage it. There are other ways, like things to avoid for getting my acne to get worse, like sleep, things I eat, how to change my skincare products around. And also I realized that hormonal acne, even at this age of 35, I can't really help it. So especially around my period, I know those are hormonal acnes. So I make sure not to touch it. I make sure not to pop it because as soon as I'm done with my period, it just like magically goes away. This is a good question. Should you let one product dry before putting on another one? And this is something that I also always wondered about when I was younger. And I don't know the exact answer, but I'm going to tell you guys what I think. If you guys search up skincare routines, you guys probably notice that for the steps, it's usually like lighter products to thicker products. So like toner, lotion, and then it gets thicker to like eye creams and night creams. I think that's why like the last steps are usually the thicker, like richer creams because it is thicker and it might take a little bit more time to absorb into the skin. So in my routine, like when I use my essence and serums and moisturizers, it usually kind of absorbs into my skin quickly. For my moisturizers, I might wait like 1 minute until it fully absorbs into my skin until I do my next step. What do you use to help with acne scars? I mentioned before, vitamin C is really good for scars, and also bio oil is actually really good for scars as well. I have a bigger one, but I don't know where it is right now. But yes, bio oil helps the scars and for stretch marks as well. What is your skincare during pregnancy and breastfeeding? So when I was pregnant and when I was breastfeeding, I was so like picky with things that I used. I did a lot of research and my skincare routine, I like took out all my acne products and switched it to like very gentle cleansers like Cetaphil, I think that's what it was called. I used Cetaphil cleanser and their lotion. At that time, my skincare was very simple. It was just like cleanser and lotion. Getting rid of blackheads. So years ago, I used to use the pore strips, but I realized that that was kind of bad for my skin. It like kind of killed my healthy cells and it left my pores open. So the dirt and oil just went back in and got clogged again. So I stopped using those strips a long time ago. So what you can do is you can switch your cleanser to something that contains salicylic acid, which will help clean like deep inside your pores and also help exfoliate. Whenever I have a lot of blackhead on my nose, I actually go to my dermatologist because they have really nice skincare like technologies. And now whenever I go, they use like this little suction vacuum thing. It's like, it looks like a pen and they just like kind of like suction everything out. So my whole pores disappears and then they do stuff so that the pores close back up and end it with a cool face mask. Do you know any face packs that can be made at home? So when I was young, I remember doing this with my mom all the time. So she would cut cooled cucumbers and we take turns and put cucumbers on each other's faces. And I still do that a couple times now. Some people add like honey in it. Some people add oatmeal or avocado. You can also add cider apple vinegar. So definitely try a cucumber pack at home. What is your favorite brand for Korean sheet masks? They are my Leaders masks and I love them. I have like 10 different masks from Leaders and I just love every single one of them. It doesn't bring me out and my face feels so hydrated after using them. Do you keep your skin clear despite wearing masks for hours? Days that I wore my makeup, I noticed that I was breaking out more under my mask because you're like sweating under there and all the dirt and stuff are getting into your pores. So now if I know I'm going out somewhere and I'm not going to be taking off my makeup, I just kind of apply makeup here around my forehead and do my eye makeup and not wear any makeup on my lower part. And also make sure to change out your mask. Don't wear the same dirty ones over and over again. So those are some of my Q&A questions. Let me know if you like this type of video. Maybe I'll do a separate video just on Q&A so I could answer more questions. Thank you so much for watching. If you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe. And I'll talk to you guys really soon on my next video. Bye, guys!